Welcome to Java Forum. Today we are going to see how to install and configure MySQL 8.0.11 Community Server Edition in Debian 8.11 operating system. So before I proceed to install, so I am giving my basic information about this virtual machine. So this is Debian 8.11 virtual machine. So now I am going to extract the MySQL .gz file for Linux, which is already downloaded from oracle.mysql website. So I am going to extract this .gz file. So I extracted this .gz file to a directory. Extraction was successful now. So here I extracted in my home directory itself. So I am renaming the directory now. So this is for convenient, I am renaming. So this is the directory structure of the MySQL 8.0 Community Edition. So bin folder consists of a lot of utilities to run and stop the database. So these are the utilities used to create, run and stop the databases. So a lot of utilities are there. So this is the lib folder. So these are the library files used by MySQL 8.0. So before I'm going to install, I want to install the prerequisite. So prerequisite means the library files required by MySQL 8.0 database to be run. So first library is libaio. So AIO library is used by a lot of database around the world. So this is the very, very important package which should be installed by default. So I'm installing this libaio. So make sure that you have same version also. So this libaio I have downloaded from internet. So libaio installation was completed. So this is Debian 8.11 operating system. Make sure that your libaio is compatible with your operating system. So after installation of libaio, so here you can see that this library was installed in /lib x86_64-linux-gnu folder. So now I am going to install libnuma. So this library will use to control the NUMA policy. NUMA means non-uniform memory architecture. So make sure that you have same version of libnuma library for Debian 8.11 operating system. So I am installing that libnuma library also. So libnuma library also is required by MySQL 8.0 Community Server Edition. So here you can see that the libnuma library was installed in /user/lib/x86_64-linux-gnu folder. So now the two libraries was installed successfully. Prerequisite was installed successfully. Now I am going to initialize the MySQL database. So first thing is I have to log in. I'm going to open the terminal. So I'm going to bin directory of the MySQL. So now I have moved to bin directory of the MySQL in the terminal. So these are the commands available. So first command is .mysqld initialize. So this is the first command you have to run. So this will initialize the MySQL database. So a temporary password is generated during the initialization. Make a note of this password. This password, through this password only you can log into the MySQL terminal. So initialization of MySQL server is completed now. So initialization means it will create some data directory, everything, all the settings it will create. So I am copying the generated, temporarily generated password to some text file. So the initialization was completed. So I have saved the password. So now I am going to show you the data directory. So the data directory you can see was initialized here. So data directory was situated in MySQL folder itself. So I have not configured a data directory in separate path. So make sure that you do not touch your data directory, so it will be get corrupted. So now I am going to start the MySQL daemon. So .mysqld is the command used to start the MySQL daemon. So here you can see MySQL started, so running as a process. So running in the port 3306. So minimize this terminal. So I'm opening another new terminal. So now I am going to run the queries. So open the terminal. So go to the bin directory of MySQL. So now I am giving the username and password which was generated temporarily during the initialization. So .mysql is the command used to log into the MySQL terminal. So this will use to run the queries. So I'm pasting the password now. Yes, so login was successful. So now I am going to run the query show databases. So show databases was failed because you have to reset your temporarily generated password using the alter user statement. So below is the query used to alter your temporarily generated password. So alter user root at localhost identified by the temporary password, the new password name. Good. now I can see that root password is altered, root user password is altered. Now you can run the query show databases. So these are all the databases used by MySQL. So I am going to create my own database called test. So using the statement create database, so create database test is the query. So now the test database is created. So you can see it was listed down. So now I am going to use the test database. So inside the test database, I am going to create a table called student. So create table student ID, and the type is integer. It's a primary key, and another field called name of type varchar. So the table was created successfully. So now I am going to insert some records to the student table. So I'm selecting that records. So create table, inserting a record and selection of a table was successful. So let us see in the data directory. So here you can see that test database which I have created here. So inside that student table, this is the files you can see in the data directory. Make sure that you do not touch your data directory. So now what I'm going to do is I am going to shut down the MySQL process which is running in the port 3306. So if I give control C, it's not stopping. So killing the process is a bad habit. So instead you shut down the MySQL process using the below command which I am going to show. So /mysqladmin. So this utility will use to stop the MySQL process which is running. So /mysqladmin, username root and password. So the shutdown. So shutdown is the command. So this is the command used to stop the MySQL process running. So here you can see the MySQL process was shut down successfully. So guys, installation of MySQL 8.0 is successful in Debian 8.11 OS.